Hello everybody, Andrea Majewski here. So how do I explain periodontal disease to my patients? Number one is use an intraoral camera, okay? That is the best thing to do. So for every patient that I have, I take the intraoral photos first and I chart inside their mouth and I say it out loud. So I might say things like, there's an MODBL on the 1/6, the gum is red, swollen, and bleeding. On the 1/5, nothing. Things look good. The 1/4, there's an MO composite. The gum is also bleeding, you know. So I will say these things out loud. And then when I am doing the probing, I will say it out loud too. So I'll say 3-3-3-4-0-5, bleeding around this one here, 6-6-2, you know, whatever, right? I'm just kind of calling out numbers. But teaching models help, okay? So I got this from Amazon. If you guys are interested, oh, I've got some stuff there. I will leave the link for you guys on the bottom. Amazon is awesome for teaching models. You can get this online from a dental supply company for twice the price. This was $38.99, okay? Amazing, I love it. Models help, patients need to see it. So check this one out, you guys. So you can see normal, early, moderate, advanced, and then occlusal trauma. So you can kind of show them this. The black, I'm assuming, is tartar that they want to show you. The yellow is tartar too and like plaque, right? But the main thing to look at the gum and the bone level, okay? So I like to show that to my patients. I like to show them both sides also, okay? So I might say to them, okay, so most of your teeth look like this. You see how the gum is nice and tight around the tooth, but these teeth here at the back look like this, okay? This is advanced periodontal disease. You have an advanced infection in the mouth, and then I will show them this. You see how like tartar plaque, right? Right here. When the gum is so low, you see how it's too low and the root is showing through. This is why you are cold sensitive. This is why that teeth hurts. You want the gum to be up here, you know, hugging the tooth. Yours is pretty far down. So that's how we can see that there is bone loss happening. But the good news is, so I do always say there's good news, even if things look horrible, you guys, and they have to come 3 months for the rest of their life. I will always say, but the good news is you have caught things now. In a month, things would be so much worse. So it's a good thing you have come in. The good news is we can get this healthy again, much healthier than how it looks now. If you come for a teeth cleaning every 3 months, I can actually get down here and clean everything really, really well. Your toothbrush can only do so much. So that's where my lovely instruments come in to clean all of that plaque, tartar, bacteria off of it for you. So that way things will look so much healthier. You see here, there's a little bit of black, there's a little bit of yellow. Here, there's a lot of black, there's a lot of yellow. You want to get here, okay? Things won't be perfect. The gum might not be this high even, but we can prevent things from getting even lower and then losing that tooth. You don't want to lose any teeth, right? So come in every 3 months. That's all you have to do to save your teeth. Brush every day, twice a day. I will likely talk to them about the water pick at this point. Mouthwash they will need to be using to limit the bacteria in the mouth. So I will talk to them. But you see how I made that sound easy and not confusing? I didn't yell at them. If you say things like, okay, you have periodontal disease everywhere. Things are really, really bad. You need to be coming every 3 months. Let me just book that for you. Okay, how does next Friday sound to finish the rest here? Because things do look really, really bad. It's going to hurt. There's going to be a lot of bleeding. You see how that doesn't sound very enticing? Even if the patient likes that attitude, because some patients like to be, you know, firm talked to, they're not going to understand. They will say, periodontal what? What do I have? Why do I have to come in every 3 months? You need to explain to them why they should be coming every 3 months, how you are going to help them, and find one spot in their mouth that looks good. Even if it doesn't look good, it probably looks better than this, right? Always mix the good and the bad. So does that help you guys? I love this model. I will leave the link for you guys on the bottom. Let me know if I didn't explain something. If you have any questions at all, make sure to click like, you guys, so I know people are watching. This is fun for me. And if you haven't yet, make sure to click subscribe, because I do upload the videos often, and it's just nice to know that people are listening. So thank you guys so much, and I'll talk to you guys in the next one.